In this video, I'm going to show you how to capture traffic. But in this example, it's going to be voice over IP traffic. In other words, we're going to capture traffic between virtual phones, as shown here, as well as virtual phones and physical phones. I'll answer the phone. This is a call from a physical phone to a virtual phone. Testing. One, two, three. My name is David Bumble, and I'm talking to myself. It's not strange at all. I'm going to make calls between these two phones, and then we're going to capture the traffic and then replay the voice call. And we're going to use Wireshark for that. Okay, so let's have a look at this practically. Here's an example. I'm using GNS3 to run a virtual infrastructure. I've got two PCs, PC1 and PC2. These are Windows computers. So here's PC2, here's PC1. They are Windows 10 computers, and I'm running IP phones on these computers. So these are older IP communicator phones. Don't worry too much about the technical details of the phones. Basically, these allow me to make calls from one phone to the other. So as an example, I can set up a call from one phone to the other. I'm getting a lot of feedback here because these two phones are running on my single computer, and you typically don't make a phone call from one phone to another that's right next to each other. So the audio is going round and round and round between these two phones. But the point is that I can make a phone call and I'll be able to capture the voice traffic using Wireshark. I've also got a Cisco Communications Manager Express router here. That's the router that's setting up the calls between the phones. Again, don't worry too much about this. Typing show run here allows me to see the running configuration of this router. I've got a DHCP pool configured to allocate IP addresses to phones. Scrolling down, you can see the telephony service. This is the part that actually allows phones to communicate with the router. Now, what I want to point out here is notice the IP address of the router and notice the port number. Port 2000 is the skinny protocol. That is a control protocol that sets up communication between the phones and the router. Basically, the router tells the phones about each other and sets up the call between the two phones using this port number. So it's a TCP port 2000. I'll show you that in a moment when we run Wireshark captures. You can see the first phone has this number. This is the second phone's telephone number, various other telephone numbers configured. Here are details of the IP phones. So we can see MAC addresses and other information. But again, we're not going to worry too much about the Call Manager Express or Cisco Unified Communications Manager Express router configuration. This is just to try and give you a bit of background about what's going on. Show ePhone shows us that we've got multiple phones. So here's ePhone 1. It's registered. It has this telephone number, 1000. Here's ePhone 2. It's registered with the router. This is the telephone number of the phone. At the moment, neither phone is making a phone call. So what I'm going to do is capture traffic on this link. So right-click Start Capture. GNS3 makes it really easy to capture packets using Wireshark because GNS3 has Wireshark integrated with it. So I can specify that I want to capture Ethernet traffic on this link and click OK. Wireshark starts automatically, and as you can see here, I'm seeing a bunch of protocols like STP, DTP, so that's spanning tree. This is dynamic trunking protocol. This is EIGRP, which is a routing protocol. But what I could do is filter for skinny. Skinny Client Control Protocol, or SCCP, is the communication protocol once again used between the phones and the router. So notice Skinny Client Control Protocol. You can see it's a TCP protocol. This is a message from the router to a phone. So the source port is 2000 going to a random port number. Here's an example from the phone to the router. So notice source port is this, destination port is 2000. This is the IP address of PC2. I've put these two PCs in different subnets. in this topology. But so that you can see this, notice ipconfig shows us that the IP address is 10.1.2.1. Just make that a bit bigger. So notice 10.1.2.1. The IP address on this side is 10.1.1.1. So notice 10.1.1.1, 10.1.2.1. The router has IP address 10.1.1.254. So this is communication between PC2 and the router. Notice TCP is the protocol used at layer 4. So IP at layer 3, source and destination IP address, TCP at layer 4. We can see source and destination port number. And this is the communication protocol between the phones and the router. Okay, but that's probably not what you're interested in seeing. You're probably interested in seeing UDP traffic. Now here we see some other traffic, some Dropbox traffic. That's not really what I'm interested in. I'm interested in seeing telephony traffic. Now, when I go to telephony, VoIP calls in Wireshark, at the moment I don't see any voice calls. But when I make a call from one phone to the other, so let's make a call from 1001. Just make that a bit quieter, to 1000. Call is set up. On this side, I can answer the call. And again, I'm going to get the feedback. Hello.
Hello.
This is David Bumble speaking. A lot of echo. Bit strange that I'm talking to myself. But there you go. Phone call from one virtual phone to another. Now, what I'll do is mute the lines so we don't get all that feedback. But there's a call set up between the two phones. In Wireshark, telephony VoIP calls allows me to see that this is an active call. What I'll do now is end the call. So notice the call has ended. And back in Wireshark, telephony VoIP calls, notice the call is completed. It's a skinny call from 1001 to 1000. So Wireshark is picking up that there was a call taking place on the network. Scrolling down, I see this UDP traffic. I see media independent network transport. It's got it listed as mint, but this is actually incorrect. This is an incorrect classification. I know this is a call from this IP address to this IP address because VoIP calls tells me that. I can see the IP address involved in the call. So I've got these two phones talking to each other. So what I'm going to do, and this is the trick, right click, decode as, and don't use mint in this example. We're going to use RTP. So scrolling right down, RTP, real-time protocol. I want to decode this traffic as RTP traffic. And notice the difference. I can see that this is G711 ULAW. G711 is a codec used for encoding analog voice. When I'm speaking, this is an analog waveform. So I'm sending voice into the air, and that's an analog waveform in the air. So in this example, the IP phone, not the iPhone, but the IP phone is taking my analog voice, which is sent through the air, and encoding it as zeros and ones. And that uses what's called a codec. We have a coder, a decoder, codec. The codec used here is G711. We have G711 ULAW, notice the U or ALAW. ULAW is what's used in the USA. ALAW, I like to remember, is all of us. So that's not entirely true. It's people like me in the UK, we would generally use ALAW when making calls on a traditional telephony network like through British Telecom. But this is IP. These are Cisco IP phones. So they use ULAW by default. So G711, ULAW. There are different codecs such as G729, G722. There are other codecs, but In this example, this is the codec that we're using. Now, you may not be interested in all of that detail, but notice here we've got real-time transport protocol. We can see the payload. Once again, notice G711. But probably what you want to do is the following. Go to telephony, go to RTP, RTP streams. And notice here we can see the source and destination streams. Now, in voice over IP, on Cisco phones as an example, there are two unidirectional streams for a two-way conversation. So if I'm talking to you and you're talking to me, there's a unidirectional stream from me to you and then a different one from you to me. Two different streams. And that's why we see it as two streams here. When troubleshooting voice over IP as an example, you often need to troubleshoot one-way voice. And the reason it's one-way voice is because there are two unidirectional streams. If there's a firewall, as an example, blocking your voice getting to me, you'll be able to hear me, but I won't be able to hear you. Again, unidirectional. So I'm going to select those two streams and I'm going to click Analyze. So here's the output of that. We can see as an example forward and reverse calls, and we get information such as the maximum jitter, which is the variable delay in a voice call. If your jitter is too high, the voice quality degrades dramatically. A whole bunch of information, but what I want to do here is click play streams, and now what I'll be able to do is play the audio stream. And again, I'm going to get the feedback. Hello. This is David Bumble speaking. A lot of echo. Bit strange that I'm talking to myself. So notice there are two streams here. We've got two separate streams. The blue one is from phone 2 to phone 1. The gray one is from phone 1 to phone 2. Hence, getting a lot of replay. What I could do is just select one of the streams and click Analyze. So what I've got here is one stream only, rather than two. And again, I'm going to get the feedback. Hello. This is David Bumble speaking. So notice I am able to grab the audio stream off the wire and then replay it. I can replay both streams. It's a bit weird here because I'm talking to myself and there's only one person in the conversation. But what I could do is do another one. And let's actually do it in the reverse direction. So I'm going to make a call now from 1000 to 1001. I'll answer that. Testing. This is call two. A lot of feedback. What I could do is disable the mic that disables the feedback. Unmute that. David talking to himself. I'll end the call. So scrolling down, you'll see there's some UDP traffic again. Now going to telephony VoIP calls, notice there are two separate calls now. Two separate calls. What I'm going to do now is do another capture. My Wireshark crashed. So let's see if we can capture another voice call. So I'm going to filter for UDP again. And what I'll do in this example is make a call from 1000 to 1001. This is my second call. David Bumble speaking to himself. I'll end the call because of the feedback. Okay, call is ended. So back in Wireshark, telephony VoIP calls, we can see the call here. So we can see there's a VoIP call. And then what I'll do is go to RTP, RTP streams. Now it's not picking it up because once again, I need to decode this traffic as RTP and not MINT. So RTP, click OK. G711 ULAW, telephony, RTP, RTP streams. We can see G711 ULAW, click Analyze, click Play Streams, and there's our voice call.
This is my second call. David Bommel speaking to himself.
Okay, so there you go. What I'll do at this point actually is save my capture so that you've got it. So I'll go back into GNS3 because otherwise it doesn't work properly. Stop capture, file, save, and I'll say saved RTP second call. Okay, so there's an example of capturing voice over IP calls between two phones using Wireshark. Now, GNS3 makes this easy because I can simply capture on different links in the topology. In the real world, you'd have to either use span, so span a port or mirror a port, if you want to use that term, or inject a hub or another device into the network so that you can see the traffic. GNS3 does make this a lot easier because we don't have to worry with physical connections. We don't have to try and span ports. We can see the traffic very easily in this GNS3 topology. Okay, but now let's look at physical phones. Can we capture voice over IP calls between a physical phone and a virtual phone? Let's try and do that. Now, to connect GNS3, I need to connect the switch to this cloud. It's basically bridging the GNS3 network to my physical network. So I've created a connection between the virtual and the physical network. That'll allow this phone to register. Now, it may take a while to register, but once it's registered, I should be able to make calls from this physical phone to the virtual phones in my GNS3 topology. Here's the GNS3 router. So show ePhone. At the moment, it says that the third phone has registered. It's a 7970. It's got this IP address. It's got this telephone number. So I should, in theory, be able to make calls from my physical phone to these virtual phones. So let's try that together. So hopefully you can see that. I'm going to go off hook. You can hear the phone dial tone. I'll dial 1001. And notice over there you can see the phone is ringing. So I've got a call from a physical phone to a virtual phone. I'll answer the call. I'll go off hook here.
I'll go off hook here.
So there's a bit of delay. But again, you don't typically talk to yourself and have phones that are so close to each other. Testing. This is a call from a
physical phone
to a virtual phone.
To a virtual phone.
And I'll put the phone down. Okay, but what we actually want to do is use Wireshark to capture that. So I'm going to capture traffic between the physical network and the virtual GNS3 network. So Wireshark is capturing. There's a lot of traffic on this network, so I'll keep it fairly short. Make the call again. So dial tone. You hear the phone ringing. I'll answer the phone. This is a call from a physical phone to a virtual phone. Testing. 1, 2, 3. My name is David Bommel, and I'm talking to myself. It's not strange at all. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, call has ended. I'll stop that capture in Wireshark. Now, you can filter in Wireshark. You can see there's a lot of other traffic here, like Dropbox syncing, stuff like that happening. But what we actually want to look for is some UDP traffic that looks like this. Traffic going from 10.1.1.1.20 to 10.1.1.1. Now, you might ask, how do you know that? If you go to telephony VoIP calls, you can see information about calls here. So as an example, you can see the call information from this IP address and the phone numbers. So let's decode that as RTP and click OK. Again, you can see it's G711, ULAW. So that's the default protocol used by these phones. Go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams, There are the two streams. I'll analyze that. Click play streams. Here are the streams.
This is a call from a physical phone to a virtual phone. Testing. 1, 2, 3. My name is David Bombal, and I'm talking to myself. It's not strange at all. Bye.
So again, I'm looking at both streams there. If I go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams, I'll select the source phone, which is 10.1.1.1.20, and click analyze, click play streams. Now we only get the one stream rather than the
this is a call,
the reply
from a physical phone to a virtual phone.
So here you only get the original part of the audio rather than the duplication.
This is a call from a physical phone to a virtual phone. Testing. 1, 2, 3. My name is David Bombal, and I'm talking to myself. It's not strange at all.
Okay, so that is an example of using Wireshark to capture voice calls and replay them between a physical and a virtual phone. What I'll do is save this file, and I've saved the other one as well, so that you can do this yourself. So I'll say audio, physical, virtual, ethical, hack. I'll stop this capture here. So again, what I've done is build a topology in GNS3 with some switches, a router, which is acting as a call manager or Cisco Unified Communications Manager Express router. In other words, allowing IP phones to call each other. And I've set up calls between virtual phones and set up calls between a virtual and physical phone. I mean, just as a last step, I could call that physical phone from this virtual phone. So here's my physical phone, and I'll press 3 here. Make myself deaf with a ringtone, but as you can see, it's ringing. Go off hook. Testing. This is a call from a virtual to physical phone. And there you go. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Let me know what other types of captures you'd like to see. In my Wireshark course, I do many. And I want to teach you how to capture traffic, how to analyze it. Do you understand how ARP works? Do you understand how spanning tree works? Can you use Wireshark to analyze what's going on in the network? Can you use Wireshark to look for problems?